Listen close to the story I tell. It's a rapping story of the living cell. It's a happy tune that's sort of cheery, but a real tough topic on the cell theory.
All animals, plants, and produce too are made of cells with different jobs to do. They're the basic units of all organisms, and I hope by now you got the rhythm.
It all starts with one dude named Hook, who at some course took a look. He used a scope to took his time, and cause the cell is smaller and thinner than a dime.
Say one,
two,
three,
four.
Are you ready to learn some more? The animal cell has many parts, and you must know each one by heart.
Like the corner man in the cell, the nucleus control the cell. It fits the odor like a brain, and fits like a mind into your memory.
Around the cell, you'll find another skin. The cellular membrane holds the whole cell in. But its job isn't simple, there's no doubt. It lets some particles go in and out.
Now please don't lose your science enthusiasm. Listen to the story of the cytoplasm. All around the cell, this thick fluid does go. But in the nucleus, it will not flow.
And don't forget those ribosomes. This is where the proteins come from. These proteins factories are so small, you'll agree you need an electron microscope to see.
Just when you thought you weren't having any fun, along comes the endoplasmic reticulum. These tube-like structures serve as a track to carry stuff to the membrane and back.
Now, have you ever seen any donuts without holes in the cell? Filled with stuff like H2O, and they carry food so the cell can grow.
Last of all, but not the very least, mitochondria, mighty cellular beasts. Some of their sugars into energy, so we'll call them the powerhouse of the cell.
Now, my friend, you know it well, the unforgettable story of the living cell.